You'll be late for work if you don't get going.
Terrific.
Good on you, Liz.
See you.
Bye.
What sea was that, Bea?
Do you want a thick ear, Doreen? Well, I don't know how she does it.
I didn't think she had a hope in hell either.
Travers, do you have any lectures scheduled for today?
This afternoon, Anthrop 1.
Oh, fine. Then there's not as much of a hurry for you to get away.
You mean it's all right? I can go too.
That's right.
Oh, that's terrific. Well, I'm damned if I know how she did it, but it's all right by me.
Oh, for she's a jolly good fellow, for she's a jolly good fellow.
Thank you, Clara. How'd you do it?
I just reasoned with her. Oh,
thank you. Thank you so much. I have to go. Yasu. Yasu. Bye.
Bye.
Oh, Lynn. I suppose it's real good you getting to go out and all.
Oh, I can't tell you how good.
Yeah. I really like working in the garden with you, though.
Oh, I liked it too.
Did you? Did you really?
Really?
I'm gonna miss you, though. I'll be lonely on my own.
I'll miss you too. Tell you what, why don't I bring you back something from the nursery? A little pot plant or something?
Oh, screws would take it.
Well, we could try.
Yeah. A present. I used to bring Frankie presents sometimes.
Well, I'll see what I can do. Listen, Doreen, I've got to fly. I'll miss my bus.
Oh, I can't.
Just 1 minute, Warner.
Going shopping, are we? Or maybe a nice little day at the races? What the hell are you carting those things around with you for?
I'm going to work.
Oh, really?
Mrs. Davidson says she can.
Was I talking to you, Anderson?
Mrs. Davidson said I can go back on work release.
And Karen, too.
Did she indeed?
I'll miss my bus, Miss Bennett.
Well, we couldn't have that, could we? All right.
Clara talked to the governor, got it all sorted out.
Not sorted out as it's going to be.
You do understand, Wendy?
Yes, Mrs. Davidson.
And when Mr. Goodwin arrives, he's to be shown directly to my office.
Yes, Mrs. Davidson.
Goodbye, Mrs. Davidson. And thanks. I'll see you tonight.
You'd better.
Please?
Yes.
I come to see Irini Zervos.
Me too. I'll have to fetch an officer.
That won't be necessary. You two were here yesterday, weren't you?
That's right.
Well, you're only allowed one visit per prisoner per week. Come back next week.
Next week? But we have good news.
Too bad.
You understand? This will make Irini very happy.
I couldn't care less whether she's happy or not. You can't see her today. Come back next week.
Just a moment.
Mrs. Davidson.
Let them see her, Annie. After all, she could do with some good news.
But they've had their visit and they broke regulations doing it.
There must be more to life than regulations.
They spoke in Greek.
And that's the end of the world? Their visit is at my discretion. And I'm telling you, they can see Irene. Do I need to be more explicit?
Last time they were here, they spoke in Greek. That's completely against the regulations. And don't think I won't mention that at the appropriate time.
Oh, I'm sure you will, Miss Bennett. In the meantime, they can have their visit. I suggest you take them out into the garden. I'm sure they'll find it much more pleasant out there. Miss Bennett will arrange for you to see Irene now.
It is all right? You say this? You are the boss?
Yes, I am.
Good news, very good news.
Why, what's happened?
We saw your man, Mr. Wilson. Nice man.
Yes, he is.
He told us we can stay here, safe here.
Oh, that's wonderful, but why?
More than 5 years we'll be living in this country. No one told us to leave, so we cannot be told now.
It's true, more than 5 years, we can ask to become natural people.
Naturalized?
So, it's what I say. Really?
What does this mean for Irene?
But she can stay here to Australia now. She can live with us.
Oh, I hope you're right.
Mr. Goodwin, how nice to see you again.
I wish I could say the same, Mrs. Davidson.
Oh, that sounds ominous.
It seems we have quite a few problems to resolve.
No more than any other prison, I hope.
Item, one suicide. Item, one death. Item, two escapes. Need I go on?
I hope not.
And quite apart from that, the department is concerned about stories to do with the distilling of illicit alcohol, about smuggled drugs. and about one of your officers having a social involvement with a criminal.
Quite an impressive list of charges.
It isn't my duty to lay charges, Mrs. Davidson. I'm here merely to inquire into the state of the prison administration. I'm sure any further action that need be taken will be taken by the department.
Without my even answering any of the matters you've brought up?
I'm quite sure that they'll all be adequately covered. Now, I need to go through the files of all current prisoners. Then I will hear any prisoners' complaints. Then interview the officers. I anticipate this procedure might take 3 days. At the end of that, one hopes that the air will be cleared.
One hopes so.
What are you doing?
Waiting.
I see. What have you got against petunias?
Huh?
Those plants over there, they're petunias.
Oh, no. Len will kill me.
I don't think so.
You'll tell her it's a mistake, won't you?
If you promise not to attack any more plants.
Okay, yeah. You're kidding me, aren't you?
Something like that.
I'm not sure sometimes. Do you think I'm dumb?
No, I don't think so. Disadvantaged.
Ah, it's all right then.
Why don't you ask Lynn to come and help you here?
Oh, no, because she hasn't got much time. Not now she's back on work release.
Well, why don't you ask them to put you back in the laundry?
No, because Bea and Lizzie and all them, well, they think I'm stupid. And anyway, this is where we worked, Lynn and me.
Yes, but you're not doing it very well, are you? And you're not very good at it. Not really.
Yeah, but it's our place. Mine and Lynn's. And I don't want to go back into the laundry.
All right, dear, all right. You don't have to go back. Not if you don't want to.
Don't tell them I've been grisly, will you?
Sometimes it helps to have a good cry. Oh, darling, what is it? What's the matter? Tell me.
You're just like me, Mum. She always knew when something was wrong.
Do you want to tell me about it?
Oh, I was just a kid. But I always remember how warm she was, you know? Mm. She was always warm. And she always smelled so good. Mm. You know, like lavender or something. Mm.
That's nice, isn't it? Do you want to tell me about your dad?
He was a bit of a drongo. He was always betting on the horses, and he always used to belt us up when the favourites lost. My mum ran off. Not that I blame her. I just remember the screaming. And then one morning, I woke up and she wasn't there. You know, she was gone.
This prisoner got out?
Yes.
According to a file, she's on remand.
That's right. It's an embezzlement matter, taking forever to work out.
In the meantime, she's in the company of hardened criminals, without even being convicted.
I couldn't agree with you more. She should be held in a remand section, but we don't have one.
Then why do you accept remand prisoners?
Because the courts keep sending them here. Mr. Goodwin, this is a limited facility. We simply don't have the room for a remand section.
Well, there is at Fairleigh. And I know there's space available.
I would be delighted if you could have her properly accommodated.
I assure you I can. Could you arrange to have her transferred today?
I'll do it right now.
Good. At least that's one problem we can solve on the day, huh?
Her mum and dad were real good people, you know?
Doreen,
her dad had a grocery shop and we used to get toffee, you know, the kind that lasted forever. Can't get toffee like that anymore.
Doreen, you must stop living in the past. You're very young. You have a future. You have to plan ahead.
Oh, but I can't plan past bedtime. What bloody hope have I got?
Goddard!
Yes, Miss Bennet?
I don't know what you think you're doing outside, but you can get right back to the building.
I was just taking a walk.
I said inside. I'll see you in your cell.
I'll be a witness.
What are you bleating about?
Well, if there's any marks on Claire, I'll say you did her over in the cells.
What a nasty little mind you've got.
Well, you're going to hurt her, aren't you?
Completely wrong. I'm going to help her pack.
back.
That's right. She's being transferred to Fairleigh right now. Isn't that nice?